Our blood is composed of plasma, red blood cells, white blood cells, and the platelets. When a sample of blood is spun in a high-speed centrifuge, the blood separates into three layers. The upper layer is pale-colored plasma, which makes up 55% of the blood. The plasma is composed of 90% water and contains proteins like albumin, globulin, and fibrinogen. It helps maintain osmotic pressure, transport liquids and ions, and help form blood clots. The plasma acts as a buffer in the blood, helps maintain osmotic pressure between blood and tissue fluid. Osmotic pressure is the pressure that we need to apply to stop the flow of solvent molecules from a dilute solution to a concentrated solution through a semi-permeable membrane. It also serves as a medium of transport for soluble food substances, minerals, waste products, and hormones, and helps distribute heat around the body. The lower layer is darker and composed of blood cells. These make up 45% of the blood. The red blood cells, or the erythrocytes, are biconcave discs, which lack a nucleus and have elastic membranes that allow erythrocytes to squeeze into the tiniest capillaries. The biconcave shape gives the cell its high surface area to volume ratio, improving gas exchange, while lack of a nucleus makes additional space for hemoglobin. The erythrocytes formed in the bone marrow. After 120 days of service, they are broken down in the spleen and the liver. The salvaged iron is stored in the liver, while the rest of the hemoglobin forms bile pigments. The thin middle layer is called a buffy coat. It consists of white blood cells and platelets. The white blood cells, leukocytes or phagocytes, are larger than red blood cells and are irregularly shaped. They contain granular leukocytes, which make up 65% of the composition and produced in bone marrow. Agranular leukocytes make up the rest, 35% of the composition, and are formed in the lymph nodes. They both show amoeboid movements. Leukocytes' main function is to make up the body's defense mechanism by actively seeking out and digesting bacteria and producing antibodies that destroy bacteria and neutralize their toxins. Phagocytes have lobed nuclei. They reach the site of infection and form pseudopodia or false feet. It then engulfs the bacteria and the site of infection becomes inflamed. Dead tissue, dead and living bacteria, and phagocytes form pus. This pus is harmless, dries up if left untouched, and falls off. The second component of buffy coat is platelets. Platelets are tiny pieces of cytoplasm with no nucleus, but most cell organelles for regular function. They are normally present in the bloodstream in an inactivated state. When platelets encounter a break in the epithelium, they activate with the help of various molecules, like collagen, which is not present in a healthy blood vessel. The collagen is one of the thrombogenic compounds that are responsible for platelet adhesion. It's turning the platelets sticky to each other and forming a platelet plug. An inactive protein, also called a factor in the blood plasma, is converted to an active proteolytic enzyme. The active enzyme in turn promotes the next step. Finally, after a cascade of events, prothrombin is converted to the active enzyme thrombin. Thrombin then acts as a cofactor that helps convert fibrinogen to fibrin. The resulting fibrin molecules begin adhering to one another and assemble into long fibrils. This long network of fibrils stitches platelets together, forming a stronger, more permanent clot to the damage.